years of the Kenyan banking sector and our commitment to transforming Kenya over the next 50 years.
I take great pleasure in welcoming you this morning as we celebrate 50 years of the Kenya Bankers Association. Through our journey, the association has undergone various stages of development in tandem with a fast-changing banking industry. The latest of these transformations was our repositioning exercise just 3 weeks ago. The Kenya Bankers Association has been part of Kenya's history since July 16, 1962. KBA will continue to play an active role in matters of regulation and is consolidating its role as the authoritative voice on banking in Kenya. Moreover, we want to promote innovation in the industry in a manner that ensures that customers make maximum returns from their banking experience.
Let me parade a few projects that we have partnered together with the KBA, and their success can be seen. First, we rolled out credit information sharing system. We have now a credit information sharing system. Borrowers can use actually their credit history. We can actually in future change the collateral technology in use in Kenya.
And I'm glad that many African central banks have begun to look at the ADB bonds. Now, what we are working on is something I can call, for lack of a better word, an Africa infrastructure bond by the African Development Bank. And I'm glad that many African central banks have begun to look at the ADB bonds. Now, what we are working on is something I can call, for lack of a better word, an Africa infrastructure bond by the African Development Bank. Staff of the bank want to call it Emerge Africa Bond. This is the proposal, quite modest. Suppose we begin by only asking every central bank in Africa to invest with us only 5% of their reserves. I say 5. Not 10, not 20, not 50, just 5. By the numbers staff have given me today, they will give us $22 billion. Not a lot, but $22 billion. Now, listen to me carefully. That is 3 times what the World Bank and the African Development Bank commit to sub-Saharan Africa each year. Now, it's a proposal we are putting forward seriously at the annual meeting of the World Bank and IMF in Tokyo. I intend to get together Minister of Finance and Governor of Central Bank. We discuss it. They say journey begins with a small step. Some will agree, others won't, but I hope all of them can agree. If they don't agree with 5%, let's begin with 2% or 1.5%, but let us begin.
First of all, may I say that speaking on behalf of Treasury, that we appreciate the comments that Kenyans have made on the VAT bill, but I think there's a misconception about the purpose. There are a lot of more reforms in the bill. People have just looked at the items. What you are now saying is, at the moment, the bill does 3 things. One, it reforms the VAT system, makes it easier for manufacturers, makes it easier for exporters. That is one. Secondly, it does away with this refunds business. At the moment, manufacturers and exporters are owed more than 2 billion Kenya shillings in VAT refunds. So it will do away with all those.